I'm not gonna lie! What a joy it is to be here with you in this moderately sized venue! What a great pleasure, and what a joy it is to look down and see vacant chairs in this allegedly sold-out night! Nothing in the world makes me happier. I remember when I was a child, I said to my father, I said, Dad, I've got one ambition. I just want to partially fill a broom cupboard. I want to partially fill a broom cupboard and fill it with people. I'm either going to be a moderately successful comedian or a very talented serial killer. And today I see some smiling faces, and for once not one of them floating in a glass jar. So good, good, the police won't be called. I hope they were, they could fill up these fucking chairs. I'm not going to lie. And I say this with genuine, genuine bloody love. You know, you don't see many double acts anymore, and I thank both of them for showing us why. Off, settle down. Don't make to Amnesty International, you pretentious cunt. One guy, you can't make fun of those two. Yes, I can. Their lives are pain. I say that. And also, with genuine love, mate, whatever he just did to you was the most sexually invasive thing I've ever seen. I was genuinely like, this must be what it's like to be polished by the interior of a bishop. It was a strange time. A strange, confusing time, and I want you to understand that I look down at you, and the thing that makes me happiest is you and I look like we're members of the same band. It's not a bad thing! I'm not gonna lie, I write the songs, I sing the songs, you play the keyboard, and carry the keyboard. And you, with genuine love, has anybody let you know how much you look like the manager character from a series I currently forget the name of? I'll come back to you. No, I fucking won't. Did you just lean in with a suggestion? No, that's fine, because we can take it from happy, simple comedian banter to your friends have had these thoughts about you for some time. Just one man leaning forward go, I know exactly what it was. We've never told you. We're waiting for your funeral. When you're dead, then we'll laugh. Then we'll say, oh, if only he was that character. Then, no, then we'd be sad because that character was dead. They've never liked you. Which is why, for whatever reason, everyone else has been allowed to wear a shirt to be, say, grey. Actually, a grey Game of Thrones shirt. Well, I'm not going to lie. We're the same person. You, a fine black shirt, I'm not going to lie, this is our roadie here. You, the man who does our hair. And you, God bless you, who they just went, I'll just turn up after work, it's fine. We'll be in our coolest clothes, but you, don't worry about it, just dress like an out-of-work Scientologist. There's nothing wrong. I also realised I could have gone for actually employed Mormon, but that's not important right now. I say this with love, but you may think to yourself, and also I will just point out, he is laughing while sitting in a very sexually confident way, while chewing gum. I'm not going to lie, and did you just... Thank God. I just thought for a moment you'd swallowed it just because I'd drawn attention to you. I'm glad you didn't do that, although, ladies, you can swallow it when I draw attention. Shut up now. Yeah, I will point out that would have been your chance to go, oh, and be right. You could have stood up for the ladies. Chivalry's not dead. It's just sitting there and it's stupid and has no reaction time. With genuine bloody love. I do, I love all of you people. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter if you're in this beautifully well-populated area. It doesn't matter if you're in this much less popular area. For some reason, I don't know why you're here with only one other person. You and I have been to the same hairdresser. There's nothing. I know. Look, can I just point out that if I come and stand down next to you, an entire audience of people will go, oh, that's Noah. That's right. Not going to lie. I just tried to say nice, and I'm Australian, and I literally felt noise come out. John, for God's sake, your mother will be so upset. All those drama lessons you've clearly had. Come on! I was just going to point out that if I stand next to you, a whole crowd of people will go, isn't that nice?
But that's voice.
Will they? Can I just point out that when you do it, it's racist? What she just said, which was great, was she just went, I'm Australian, to which I say, yep, that proves my point. You see, why not? Actually, now that we've made that point, I was going to make the point that if I stood next to you, people would go, how wonderful, the Malfoys are back together. But now if I stand next to you, they go, oh, fuck me, what are the rest of the Trump supporters getting in? Because I'm not going to lie, you know, the English, I mean, the English invented racism, but the Australians, we perfected it, you know? It's a genuine thing, you know? I mean, look, say what you will for apartheid, at least it was a system. Because the Australians, we're the ones who invented casual racism, you know? We're the ones who's like, it's not a hate crime, mate, it's a fucking Wednesday. Ah! You know? That's our thing. It's fucking horrifying. You know, here's an Australian knock-knock joke. Knock-knock, who's there? Immigrants. No, there you go. That's why it's pleasant to be here. It's pleasant to be among you. It's pleasant to be with you, the weird... You wanted to sort of be the social barometer, didn't you? But then it kind of failed, just like that beard. Now, that's right! Stand up for him! He has failed you, but let him know you love him. He's fine. He has the beard of a shit Satan. But it doesn't matter. Sit next to a man with the beard of an actual Satan and the sweater of a down-at-heel Bill Cosby. Right! I say this with genuine love. Fuck it, I'll play a game. Right! Thank you! Nugget, what is this?
Grosh!
What? Grosh! Ah! A man who does not simply say the nature of the fluid, but rather the brand. You, sir, are why capitalism has failed us all. One man saying, I want you to understand the quality of what you've stolen. Grosh! My darling, I say unto you, that I choose to treat this, not gonna lie, all beer smells the same. I choose to treat this delightful amber fluid the same way the English treated our country. So this is mine now, and I will apologize to you in 200 years. Very little practical effect. Upon witnessing a theft, will immediately go, yes, it's good you have done it. I have spent my life avoiding the gaze of strangers on the tube, but you take that thing from the man and then later kill him and feast on his innards. Yes, it's everything we've ever wanted. See, it's a wonderful thing as you people, all of you people have been trained since Panto. To respond to any old dumb shit. He's behind you. Oh no, he isn't. Oh yes, he is. That's how we're going to catch that sex offender, ladies and gentlemen. There's something delightful about making that statement and two men clap in what I can only assume is recognition. Now, again, stop missing your cue. Social justice buzzer. We need you to let us know when it's wrong. We'll always need a middle class white guy to let us know when it's wrong. Said the man who looks like an albino Christ. I will point out, why not? This is the finest thing I ever heard about my appearance. My wife heckled me once. I was going down on it. To hear what that statement does to people. Cunninglingus is a beautiful thing. Some of you have sort of just responded to that like I just said, and then I was going down on your wife, you know? Yeah. She faked me. Now, this is what my wife did. She heckled me while I was going down on her. Now, this is a brave decision, because this is somebody saying, I actually require the pleasure you're giving me less than the joy I'm about to get from hurting your feelings. And I was between her thighs, and she put her hand on the back of my head, and she went, Khaleesi. The mother of dragons. Now, thank you. Thank you, one person whistling, and you with the t-shirt from the show. Nothing. Nothing at all. Fuck you and fuck your Dothraki kid, mate. Is that a thing? I've never seen the show. I love all of you people. I love each and every one of you people. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter if you're this young man who, God bless you, they sort of nailed your arms like that. Just a man who's just been enjoying the show, the folly. Just a man being a frog resting on a lily pad. Waiting for the humour. If it never arrives. You having the most wonderful time. You having pretty much this. Also, can we just play a fun small game? Just you and I for a moment. Yeah. What I like about you is, one, your responses are casual. Two, they are silent, which helps me in no way. Three, I feel that there's a great depth of meaning behind it, but also it's just a man going, ah. I see that once again, the burning eye of attention is upon me. Yeah, he just did this like that. So you know when you see someone shrug with their mouth, and you're like, that's fucking incredible. How have you managed to do that? You're the only person who, if I put my penis in you, you could nonchalantly make me come. He just did it again, which is exactly how you do it. I would dye that beard white. Now! Tumblr. Now. Lol. Now. I just want to just come, just stand up. Just stand up momentarily, if you'd be so good. Stand up momentarily, turn to these people, and we're just going to play it. Look at them. I hope you knew they were there. I just want to play a small game of can we just all appreciate how much this man looks like Anthony Ainslie, the man who played the Master in Doctor Who for fucking 10 years. Have a look. Sit down. Yep, that didn't work. You know when you think a pop culture reference will do something, and then suddenly you just encounter a room full going, you know, actually I do know who you're talking about. That's not his name for a start. And he doesn't. There we are. Not gonna lie. You failed me, mate. Nothing wrong with that. I choose to tell you a story at this juncture. Juncture, a fun word. There's a room of people go, what do you mean juncture? Have you started? Do a joke. Yeah.
We'll also point out there's something quite delightful about realising that what I seem to have down here is a kind of failed Last Supper situation. Very nice. And also, as I move slowly towards it, I realise every drink on that table empty, thus useless. What's that?
Why?
No
beer. Now, see, the problem there was what happened was intention met politeness. Because what you just did was the most English thing you've ever said, which was to realise when I was going to take the wine, to go, please no. You know, but you're not playing by the rules. But if you eat with the wrong fork, how will we be able to, oh good lord, he's taken it away. However will I express my pain? Not by drinking as was the plan. Oh gasp, I suppose I shall have to say nothing. Ah, bum. Yes.
Your friends did the most English thing possible, which was not stop me.
Four of you, together, collectively, going, ah, the man who bought me in minutes ago stole that. I see him now, walking towards us. I wonder what his intention is. For wager me, perhaps it is the same but as before. And yet, we shall all instinctively think to ourselves, but my drink, mine is empty. And mine too is empty. No, only little Bellamy down there. My only Bellamy has been. Shall we do anything now that we were educated at a fine school? We can do nothing. But when we are 40, we will look back and remember this day, jovially stealing her drinks over and over again.
I will also point out the reason that this has happened to you, a couple of things. One, I'm mortally terrified of this table now.
Just because I'm currently associating them with bits of impro that don't quite work. That moment of going, over here on the table of mediocrity. Yes! I'll remember the show. Now! I fucking want... Fucking, right. Come here.
Just, yeah, run in. Those of you who are doing that, that's very good. Some would argue, totally unnecessary. I will say unto you, pleasing as fuck. Nah, are you being... Can you have it back?
Being poor.
Hold on. I want you to understand, I mean you people no lasting harm. However, I just want to point out, now what happened there, right? One person just went, drink it! Ah! Wow, this is quite good. See, what I was about to do was the one scripted bit of material I had. However, I quite like that what's now happening is the world's most polite, and shall I say, Jane Austen-esque. You're related to her? You're gonna lie, folks! And this is what I mean. I was just so racist, I was fucking accurate. I literally said Austen-esque because I went, it's a group of white women. They seem delightful. Jane Austen, and I picked out a relative. Now. It is a matter universally acknowledged that a young lady upon reaching a certain age will at some point be deployed, you did that, right, will at some point be deployed as she is the one nearest to the stage to take the white wine back. Have it. No! I'm playing this on colonialism rules. Tell you what, make life Gandhi and resist me passively. Yep, probably just me. Upon hearing the phrase, make like Gandhi, resist me passively, this was not the response anyone... Just take it. The most well-timed piece of charity we've ever seen. It could have been better timed. This could have been
full. I thank you desperately.
I took it from my son.
You took it from your son? You were right to do so. How old is it? I don't address myself to you, to the mother. How old is the boy? Don't think about it! That's why he can't have enough of this! He got enough of it in the womb! Folks, you, I say thank you.
25.
Ladies and gentlemen, you have been a lovely bunch of people. My name is John Robinson. I'm at thejohnrobinson.com. Come see me again sometime. These shows are very rarely the same.
Don't worry, the quality of the acts will decrease.
Yes.
Oh, you're amazing.